It went well. It's been almost 13 months since I played 5-on-5, and I felt great today to be back on the court, be back with the guys, and just enjoy what I truly love.
Any surprises as far as what you went through today?
Any surprises?
Yeah, on your end as far as your body and all that.
No, I felt great. I've been feeling good playing 2-on-2, 1-on-1, 2-on-2, 3-on-3, so I felt comfortable, my body has changed since I got hurt, and I feel strong on the court. I feel I'm moving well, so I'm really happy about the progress that we've made.
Now that you've gone through this first workout, 5-on-5 workout, how anxious are you to get into a game this season?
Of course, I'm very anxious, but we're gonna take our time. We're gonna look at the situation and make it. We'll see. I'm not really thinking about that right now. I'm just out here enjoying, you know, the next step, and then we'll go from here.
You haven't been playing, but you've been watching a lot of film with Rick and meeting with him and some of your teammates as well, and you've been watching them play. How beneficial is that for you to step on the court today, even though you haven't been playing, maybe feel a little more comfortable just around there?
Yeah. No, as I said, it felt great. I visualize a lot and I see myself playing, so this whole time I'm always thinking in my head, I don't want to come back and be rusty. I want to be in the game right away, you know. And I missed the shots today, but I felt good on the court. I felt comfortable. I felt fluid, and I think that's important, you know. And shots will start falling, and the more we play, the more I play. So it's good to finally be able to do something physically, you know. So I'm happy.
How do you feel about the fans in Dallas who've already embraced you and haven't played yet?
Right.
How do you feel about
exactly. I've been getting a lot of support and a lot of love, and I'm extremely grateful for how welcome, you know, how the fans welcome me here, and so I can't wait to step on the court and finally, you know, show them what I'm capable of doing.
Were there any moments today that were kind of like wow moments or something that was reassuring?
No. I just, as I said, I missed shots, but I felt good. I felt fluid on the court. I felt fast, and I felt really good physically. And you know, also I already have a high confidence because of the work that I've been putting in to get to this point. So it was really natural for me to just be back on the court and be competing and contact. And so really felt good, and I'm looking forward to the next practice.
Feel like you felt before you got injured?
Sorry?
Did you feel like you felt before you got injured?
I feel better. I definitely feel better than before. 100%. Just the way I move, the way I run, the way I jump, everything just feels more fluid.
And that's because of increased strength around the knee?
Increased strength, a lot of movement stuff that we've been working on, a lot of biomechanics stuff that we've been working on, and it's been a long road. You know, it's like walking in the desert this whole time. You're just working, and you don't know what's the end result is going to be like, you know. But now that I'm coming closer to playing and you know, I'm already doing 5-on-5 in practice, scrimmaging in practice, then I get some taste of what it's going to be like when I finally step back on a court and compete.
You said that there was a psychological hurdle at all? Do you think today was a psychological hurdle? Or
not at all. No. Not at all. I haven't really, like, That's the main thing a lot for a lot of guys is the psychological, you know, thinking about the knee. But for me, since I've been doing, you know, contact stuff and all that, I haven't really even been thinking about the knee. I don't really feel it, you know, so it's, as I said, I feel amazing. I feel great.
You said you were doing some biomechanics stuff. What does that kind of help with? Does that kind of help you in the future stay healthier long term and be a little bit better in the future?
Yeah, definitely. It's always, you know, you can always improve the way you move and the way you jump and what's the correct way to do certain movements. And that's going to help me to be faster, to react quicker in a lot of situations, and possibly help me, stay on the court for as long as I can, you know, throughout my career.
Do you see any irony in the fact that the first 5-on-5 practice with the Mavericks came 13 months to the day from your surgery?
It's exactly 13 months?
February 13th.
Oh, wow. Yeah. No, that's not how we planned, you know. It was just the progression that we had, and I could have been on the court way earlier than this, but we really took our time. We really stayed patient. I stayed really patient. I'm proud of myself for staying that patient. But now that it's here, I'm excited. I'm happy, and I can't wait for the next practice.
Thanks, man.
Rick said you and him had that conversation about what your role is going to look like on the court next season, things like that. What have those talks gone like, and you know, how do you feel confident-wise about what your role on the team will be?
I feel really confident. I really like his philosophy, the way he sees me out there on the court, and I think we're on the same page on all of the stuff that we talked about. So I'm really excited to play for Coach Carla, and it's going to be a great opportunity for me to take my game to the next level.
Do you feel like you have input? Not that necessarily you're calling the shots, but that he listens to what you like as well, and it's a back and forth.
Yeah, I think it's important that, you know, we have those conversations and we talk about stuff, and he asks me, what do I like? Certain plays, certain stuff that I like to run and where I feel comfortable in. They already know me really well. You know, they've been watching me play for a long, long time. So, but it's really good to have that. You know, to have those conversations, to have those, you know, things that we go through and we, you know, we agree on.
How much fun is it for you to be on the floor shooting with Dirk?
Oh, it was awesome. We played some one-on-one against Coach Mose, and it's always good, you know, just to watch him still, you know, do his thing and still work on his game. I mean, it's inspiring to me. It's inspiring to me to see a guy so consistent every day, just doing the same thing, you know, and he's not the same player he was a few years ago anymore. But to see just the consistency, and that inspires me, and that. Shows me what type of person he is, what type of character he is, and that's why he had the career that he's been having.
What did you miss most about being out the last year?
What did I miss the most?
Yeah.
Competing. I started playing even some video games just to compete with somebody. You know, I was so bored. That's the thing I miss the most is the competition and you know, talking some smack and just, you know, just being out there and kicking some ass. That's what I miss the most. So it's coming back. It's coming back soon.
How was your smack talk game?
You know, I'm not a big smack talk. I like my game talk more. But sometimes, you know, here and there, I say something.
How anxious are you to get on the court with Luka and see what you guys can do?
Very anxious, of course. Of course, as soon as possible. You know, as I said, the first step, you know, we made the first step today. We played together on 5-on-5 scrimmage. But the real thing is coming, so.
Do you think that there would be a benefit in playing this year, or do you think that potentially the benefit would that the risk outweighs the benefit?
I don't see any risk, honestly. You know, for me, it's not a risk. It's just whether it's, you know, it's, I don't know. I honestly don't have an answer for you, you know.
Yeah.
But the thing is, I feel healthy. I feel great. I'm anxious to get back on the court as soon as possible. And I know I'm ready. So we'll see. I don't know.
Do you see benefits to because otherwise, I guess by next year it'll be 20 months since you played in a game. But you are practicing full, so maybe
right.
It doesn't make a difference.
I don't know. I mean, like when you start a season, you usually go through preseason, so you know it's already like it's you don't start boom right away. You don't jump in a game, so. I think it wouldn't really matter. For me, I was a little worried, you know, after such a big time off, I would be a little rusty and like not feel as comfortable. But today, just all the 2-on-2 and 3-on-3 already proved me that I haven't, you know, it's right there. I still have my game, you know, and today too. So I'm not really worried about that, you know. So we'll see.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you. Thanks, guys.
Thank you for